Welcome to KEX Construction Engineering. Today, we are going to look at the comprehensive overview of foundations in construction and civil engineering. In this video, we will cover what a foundation is, the main types of foundations, and the reasons and factors influencing the choice of each foundation type. What is a foundation? A foundation is the structural element that transfers loads from a building or structure to the ground. Its key roles are to support the structure, distribute the load evenly, prevent differential settlement, and anchor the structure against external forces like wind, earthquakes, and water pressure. Without a properly designed foundation, a structure is at risk of cracking, tilting, or even collapsing. Types of foundations. Foundations are broadly classified into 1. Shallow foundations. 2. Deep foundations. Let's begin with shallow foundations. 1. Shallow foundations, used where the soil close to the surface has adequate bearing capacity. Depth is usually less than the width. 1.1. Spread footing, isolated footing, a square or rectangular pad under a single column. Load from the column is spread over a wider area of soil. Reasons for adoption. Economical for light structures, ideal when columns are spaced apart. Suitable when the underlying soil has good bearing capacity. 1.2. Combined footing. A single footing that supports two or more columns when their individual footings would overlap. Reasons for adoption. Used when columns are close together. Necessary when one column is near a property boundary and cannot be centered. Balances the load between adjacent columns. 1.3. Strip footing, continuous footing. A continuous strip of concrete under a load-bearing wall. Reasons for adoption. Common in masonry wall construction. Best when loads are linear and spread evenly. Cost-effective for structures with continuous load paths. 1.4. Raft foundation, mat foundation. A large slab under the entire building footprint. Distributes loads from all columns and walls over a large area. Reasons for adoption. Suitable for weak or compressible soils. Reduces differential settlement. Ideal when loads are heavy and closely spaced. Used when pile foundation is too expensive or impractical. 2. Deep foundations. Used when surface soils are weak and the load needs to be transferred to deeper, more stable layers. 2.1. Pile foundation, long, slender columns driven or drilled deep into the ground. Can be end-bearing resting on rock or frictional transfers load through skin friction. Reasons for adoption. Ideal for poor soil conditions near the surface. Used for tall buildings, bridges, and offshore platforms. Suitable when water table is high or where deep excavation isn't feasible. Helps resist uplift and lateral loads in seismic zones. 2.2. Pier foundation caissons. Large diameter shafts drilled into the ground and filled with concrete. Often used where open excavation is possible. Reasons for adoption. Suitable for large vertical loads. Commonly used for bridge abutments and heavy industrial structures. Offers better control and inspection compared to driven piles. 2.3. Well foundation. Deep circular foundations used in riverbeds or waterlogged areas. Constructed by sinking well-like structures and filling with concrete and reinforcement. Reasons for adoption. Preferred in underwater constructions, such as bridge piers. Withstand scour and water current pressures. Offers high bearing strength in subaqueous environments. Factors to consider before choosing a foundation. Selecting the appropriate foundation type depends on multiple factors. 1. Soil properties, strength, compressibility, and type: clay, sand, silt, rock. 2. Load requirements, weight, and distribution of the structure. 3. Water table level, affects excavation and material choice. 4. Site accessibility, space constraints, and equipment feasibility. 5. Cost and budget. Shallow foundations are cheaper. Deep ones are more costly, but necessary in some cases. 6. Type of structure, light versus heavy, short versus tall. 7. Seismic and wind loads, deeper or reinforced foundations may be needed in active zones. 8. Environmental and ground conditions, for example, coastal or marshy land. Conclusion: foundations are the core of structural safety and performance. From simple residential homes to massive bridges and skyscrapers, the right foundation ensures structural integrity, resistance to natural forces, cost efficiency, and long-term durability. Always base your foundation choice on site conditions, structural needs, and expert soil analysis. Remember, great structures begin with a solid foundation. Stay tuned for more construction videos. Thank you for watching.